Of the political science department at the University of Ghana, Dr. Bosman Asare, is calling on President Mahama to openly apologize to the people of Ghana for accepting a $100,000 Ford Explorer gift given to him by a Burkinabe contractor, Jibril Kanazoe. His call? Right. Well, his call follows an expose on Joy FM that the Burkinabe contractor Jibril Kanazoe had pulled out of an 82 million Ghana cedi contract. Let's take a listen to the political scientist.
I think I was completely taken aback when I heard that someone has successfully been able to give a gift to the president, because I know when someone occupies the position of the president, this is the highest office in this particular country. So Ghanaians expect a certain level of a high level of morality, a certain level of administrative commitment, a certain level of professionalism. So I have always been of the view that it's very, very inappropriate for someone who is a certain president of our country to receive a gift of that particular level. We know that when presidents are moving around and they get to place, they are given smocks, they are given this kente cloths, etc. But to the extent that someone has been given the contract by the government of Ghana and the person gave a gift to the president personally, to the president, I think it's completely inappropriate.
On the basis of the constitution, is it possible for any organization, any individual, any Ghanaian to say, we want to go forward and impeach the president? And how does that happen?
Now, I think on the basis of the constitution provides grounds that there are certain things when leaders do, they can be removed from office. That one is clearly established. But one of the things we have to understand in Ghana is that the nature of the system we are practicing, the political system we have in this country, some people can take the initiative. The court is always there to listen to people, whether you are rich, you are poor, you belong to a party, or you don't belong to a party. But the question is, will this thing be able to fly? And when we talk about impeachment, impeachment generally falls within the domain of the legislature. Unless someone is saying that, okay, I think the parliament will not be able to do it, so let me go through the court system. But impeachment is something which will be done by parliament. But let's look at the composition of our parliament. And looking at the system we are practicing, I don't think Ghana will get to a point where a president who has majority in parliament and the parliamentarians who say we are going to support an agenda or an action that will lead to the impeachment. And I think we've been hearing some MPs on the president's side who are justifying that, oh, at times the president will go around and people will be giving smokes, goats, sheep, etc. But let's be very clear, Ford expedition is different from a goat. This is a country we are having problems with corruption. We are always saying public officials are corrupt, ministers of state, parliamentarians, civil servants. Almost all of us accept that corruption has become synonymous with the Ghanaian people. But people also expect that there are certain individuals, if even we are talking about corruption, we shouldn't be mentioning their names. And one of the persons will be, let's say, the Chief Justice, the Speaker of Parliament, the President, the Vice Chancellors, Judges of the Supreme Court, etc. So once people are hearing that even someone was given a contract by the government of Ghana, and that same person gave a gift to the president, and the gift is worth something more than $100,000, then you hear ordinary people saying that, oh, if even the president can do that, then we don't have to blame any individual.
It becomes law that for a public official, every gift that you actually get in any form or kind, you must make sure that it is published in a certain way, whether on a website. In South Africa, people in parliament have to make sure even perfumes that they receive is actually declared online. Don't we have to get there as a country? We say, yes, you have to declare, but we don't really see where the declaration happens. What's your opinion on that?
But ideally, that's an ideal situation. That's what it's supposed to be. But I established that we have been a country that is a work in progress. And when you look at Ghana, especially in Ghana, we normally in public policy, there is something we call incremental policy. In other words, changes are so minimal, changes are in small phases, and we also have non-incremental. Ghana, as for many years, we have chosen the incremental route. We are making progress, but you can see the progress is very slow. We mentioned South Africa. We started this democratic journey before they did in 1994, but they appear to be very non-incremental. They appear to have put structures in place. Institutions appear to be working better than we have in our system. And here we have a situation whereby individuals are still manipulating institutions. So ideally, in a perfect environment, we expect that we will get to a point where any public official, whatever you receive from someone, must be declared. And at times, it may be necessary for you to pay a component of that to the income tax or the tax authorities in general. We expect those who are at the helm of affairs should be leading. Then it will trickle down to the ministers of state, the speaker, parliamentarians, whatever you get from someone. As long as the person is saying it's a gift, some payment must be made to the state. Until we got to that level, I don't think we will be able to do the things as a country we really wanted to do.
What about the president coming out and saying, I'm sorry? Will that work for you? Will that work for the Ghanaian people? Will that say that indeed, as leader, he recognizes that this has not washed down quite well with some portions or certain people within the Ghanaian community? Will an apology work? Do you think it's something that can be considered?
Let me use this again. Ideally, in a well functioning society, in a society where democratic structures are firmly built, you expect the leader to come out openly to tell the Ghanaian people that I did not act in an appropriate way. Ideally, to say sorry to the Ghanaian people. But Ghana is not an ideal situation. This is a country, especially going into the elections November, and this is going to be one of the high-stake elections in our country. For the president to openly come out and admit, people will say, the people around the president will say, no, you are giving ammunition to the opponent. But ideally, I think that the president should apologize to the Ghanaian people. And I think that it's not going to really inure to the disadvantage of the president. People will see that you are also a human being. And we've had instances in other countries. Recently, we heard about the South African president, Mr. Zuma, coming out openly to admit that he apologized to the South African people and that what he did, renovation of his house, there were certain things he didn't understand. So the people should forgive him, and even went further to say that he will make payment, he will pay the money to the state. So I think that in a well-functioning society, even the people around you are going to tell you that this thing, we didn't do it well. But we know we live in a country where the people around you will encourage you that, oh, this thing has been done severally. But if you are a leader and you are thinking of being a great leader, being viewed in the perspective of a great leader, these are some of the things you must admit. Well, just by simply apologizing, I think that many people are going to stop talking about it. And it can even be an advantage to you because you are also a human being.
The contractor has retained down the sole sourcing contract to do the new roads. If he is able to turn down a contract from Ghana that would have gone to him, the roads by sole sourcing, is it possible for the office of the president to say, we're giving your forward expedition back to you? Could that be...